Alright, so welcome to the 2019 N-Level Unseen Pros section. Alright, so as usual, I'm going to take, you can take some time to read this. My style is to note which part is the feeling and which part is the thinking question. So if you notice over here, it's quite obvious. So I always call this the heart. Right, and this is different, right? So this is the, again, I'm still terrible at drawing brains, but yeah, the thinking section. So when we're doing dramatic, and this is why it's good if you do like paper two, because you would have identified dramatic as something that relates to tension and suspense, okay? Right, which is what we will need to identify later. Okay, hold on, let me just change my pen. Alright. So, usually, I would advise you to like do a split, although it's not something I always like to teach. But, yeah, where do you think is, you know what, I'm just gonna go with this method. So, where do you think the tone in this story changes? Okay, would it be somewhere around here? He's rowing towards the island, no change. Still rowing, still rowing, he hits the island. Right, will I stop here? I mean, there's a natural break. Not quite. Okay. Although I wasn't that optimistic. Seems so terribly small that I thought it must be uninhabited. Okay. So, I noticed that over here, it's still very pessimistic as compared to here. So that's why I'm not going to cut it yet. But this part, beautiful, first sign, seem to grow deeper, more trees, more birds. There seems to be a change going on, right? So you know what? I'm actually going to do my twist over here. Okay. Because this part is pessimistic. Sorry for the handwriting. And this part is optimistic. Well, I mean, is it really optimistic? That's something we'll discuss later. Okay? But let's talk about his feelings. Okay? So this part, I mean, we already have two broad feelings here, right? I think without stopping, didn't move, struggled for hours. You definitely have one feeling here, which is probably something along the lines of hopeless. Can I say disappointed? Hopeless, on the verge of giving up, maybe frustrated. If you want to use this word, but I doubt you actually know it's despondent. Okay, I'm just practicing my vocab over here. Alright, I mean, you still see this here. Tough job. Maybe I can use a different one. This is interesting. Fairy tale. So perhaps over here you can talk about relief. Yeah, this part wasn't optimistic, seems so terribly small. Notice that it links to part one. Okay, so this is still part one. Okay, let's see if we can find anything else that's part two. Okay, well, I mean, he heard the bird. I mean, this part I'll still link it as part two. And this last part, I stopped thinking he hurried. He was urgent, right? He just had to see, would find out. Yes, I think it's pretty easy. Can you say the feeling with me? In 3, 2, 1. Curiosity! Yeah! You got it! He's curious about the island. If you want to, you can say perhaps a little childlike. Right, because he stops thinking. Yeah, you can have that, sure. Moving on to the second one. Ooh, I like this color. Galaxy. Okay, so this is part 2. Well, let's see what we can find. Actually, you know what? I don't know. Is it just me or is... Okay, I mean... So... By the way, the twist is supposed to show you the two main feelings, but... Obviously, it didn't really apply for part 1. Still, I find it useful for giving me a broad overview of the change in tone, change in the story. It helps me understand it a lot better. But, you know, as the saying goes, your mileage varies. It works for you, it works. If it doesn't, it doesn't. But this is something my own teacher taught me about. A quick way to spot two different feelings. Right? And perhaps also to see where part 1 and part 2 is. Personally, I don't find it that useful, but I think if you're a beginner and you're not sure where to start, what to annotate, fine, go for it. But if you're more like advanced expert and you're looking close reading for clues that are like here and there, then you know, you don't have to follow it. But yeah, so so saying a dramatic. So I'm looking for things that create tension and suspense. You know, I can use the same part as part 1 to talk about tension, or so it's dramatic. Okay. Because I think this part I'm going to type. Uncertain if he will make it to the island or not. The use of bloody also dramatizes how stressful, dangerous his situation is if he does not reach the island soon. Okay? So I mean the sense of danger, time, urgency, yeah, you have that. And you realize that it links to part 1, right? Yeah. Can you link it to second feeling of relief though? Would it be dramatic? Is there more or less tension when he reaches the island? Of course there's less, right? So I wouldn't use that. But I could think about let's see. So now that he has reached the island, he is thinking that it's uninhabited, so can't find help. I don't know what's his goal. And you know what? It's wonderful. If you don't know his goal, then you can say it's dramatic. Right? Because I don't know his goal, I'm uncertain. Yay! So, tension, suspense, add uncertain to this. Okay. Yeah, they're optimistic. Whoops. So I'm gonna go with B. Whoa. I like this version of OneNote better. It's the latest version. Seems less error prone compared to the pre. Whoa, what did I just do? Okay. So dramatic because even though he reached the island, it is still uncertain if he will survive because it seems that no one is there to help him. He still needs to find food, water, seems to find food, water that may not be there. And he is not optimistic, I suppose you could, about surviving. I suppose you could mention the narrator is left unsaid, which makes it mysterious and dramatic because it is unclear what it means to him, how important it is, blah blah blah. All right, don't just tell me because you don't know what it is, that's why it's dramatic. Alright. Unclear what it means to him, how important it is, whether it will be revealed to us, whatever. Okay? Moving on. Part C. Actually, there's quite a few things you can say. You can say this one is mysterious. It's different. Steep hillsides. So it's a sudden change in an environment. Alright, so dramatic because, okay, I'm gonna turn off my pen. Maybe I can't turn it off. Okay, hold on now. So dramatic because sudden change in environment. The bird is not exactly a sudden change, but there's a bird that he has never heard before, blah blah blah, and he cannot see it. So again, it's dramatic because which makes it mysterious. And as the audience, we cannot help but feel. But wonder if wonder is not exactly dramatic, but want to see it too, because it is described as exceptionally beautiful. So that's like one. Maybe I wouldn't say a change in environment to something strange. Okay. Why would flowers and bushes different from any I had seen before? So why would this be dramatic? I'm thinking it's dramatic, whoops, because I don't know. Technically you can, okay, the lazy way would be to say create a sense of danger, but create a sense of, I guess if you want to say danger, that's fine, but I'm gonna go with suspense over whether they are safe or not, or what kind of place he has landed upon, because it's so different. Right? Or maybe the fact that it is so alien, unfamiliar to him, means he could have landed upon somewhere very far away from home. So he might not be able to survive, might not be familiar, might not be able to adapt. Right? Thus, unable to adapt. Right? Create a sense of danger, just worry about something. Right? Steep hillsides show a change in landscape, and the fact that he cannot see the sea when earlier he was able to see clear contours that it was a small island here along here, right? Means that his knowledge of the island is wrong / false, mistaken. So yeah, and that there might be more to the island than meets the eye. So why would this be dramatic if he is mistaken, or if there's more that he doesn't know, right? So there might be danger, especially because of the steep hillsides, which means that if he fell, he would be hurt greatly, right? Likewise, the flowers bushes, if he doesn't know what could happen, you know, might eat something, get poisoned. Likewise for the birds, right? I mean, birds are one thing, but what other animals did he not hear, which, you know, could be a danger to him and that he might not be equipped to handle because he's not familiar with such animals, okay? I'm pretty sure if you're a Singaporean, what do you do if you see a bear or crocodile, right? Things that animals that other countries might be more familiar with. Okay, so that's about it. If there's anything you're not clear of, please let me know. Anything you like, let me know as well, so I can continue doing that. All the best and good luck.